This is Janet Andrabir.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this video, we're going to give the expression of the mechanical energy of a system, discuss the effect of works done by conservative and non-conservative forces on the value of the mechanical energy, explain the principle of conservation of mechanical energy, relate the variation in the mechanical energy to the net work done by the non-conservative forces.
Mechanical energy. Watch this short video, where a ball is attached to the lower end of a vertical spring. When the system is released, the ball moves up and down. During the motion of the ball, the system ball spring earth may possess kinetic energy due to the motion of the ball, elastic potential energy due to the deformation of the spring, and the gravitational potential energy due to the position of the ball relative to a reference level for a gravitational potential energy. The sum of these energies is called the mechanical energy of the system. So ME is the mechanical energy equal KE, the kinetic energy, plus PE, which is the potential energy. Note that, in general, PE refers to all the types of the potential energy in the system, such as magnetic, electric, gravitational, elastic, etc. But in our curriculum, we focus on the gravitational potential energy and elastic potential energy as the two types of potential energy in the system.
In this study, we will not introduce the definition of conservative and non-conservative forces. Instead, we will focus on their effect on the mechanical energy. Now, let's start with the non-conservative forces. Observe this chair. The belt is pushed on the ground. It travels a certain distance and then it stops. As you know, the chair stops under the action of the friction force. Now, let's consider the system chair R. The mechanical energy of the system is given by this formula. ME is equal to KE plus PE. Now, the work done by the friction force results in a transformation of the kinetic energy into thermal energy. But the thermal energy is not a part of the mechanical energy. So the work done by the friction force results in a decrease in the mechanical energy. Now, the friction force is an example of a non-conservative forces. In general, the work done by a non-conservative force results in an increase or a decrease in the mechanical energy of the system. For example, the traction force, the work done by the traction force results in an increase in the mechanical energy of the system. Other non-conservative forces might increase or decrease the mechanical energy depending on the situation. Now, let me give you some examples on non-conservative forces. We have the friction. We have air resistance. This is a type of friction, sometimes called the drag. We have the traction force. We have normal forces. We have tension force exerted by inextensible strings, and muscular forces.
Now, conservative force. Observe the motion of this ball. It moves up and down. Consider the system ball earth. The mechanical energy of this system is given by kinetic energy plus potential energy, or gravitational potential energy. During ascending of the ball, the work done by the weight results in a transformation of the kinetic energy into potential energy, while during descending, the work done by the weight results in a transformation from potential energy into kinetic energy. But we know that gravitational potential energy and kinetic energy are parts of the mechanical energy, so the work done by the weight does not vary the mechanical energy. Then the weight is called a conservative force. In general, the work done by a conservative force doesn't vary the mechanical energy of the system, but it transforms its kinetic energy into potential energy and vice versa. In addition to the gravitational force, restoring force of a spring and electric force between the plates of the capacitor are other examples of conservative forces. But in our curriculum, we focus on gravitational force and restoring force of a spring are conservative forces.
Focus, please. This is important.
I'll move to the conserved mechanical energy. Consider a freely falling object. The forces of interaction in the stone-earth system are gravitational forces, which are conservative forces. In this example, the mechanical energy is conserved because there are no non-conservative forces acting in the system. Now, look at the car. It moves with a constant speed, and so its kinetic energy is constant. Also, it moves on a horizontal road, so there is no change in its altitude. Then the gravitational potential energy of the car Earth system is constant. Therefore, the mechanical energy of this system is conserved. But how could the mechanical energy be conserved in a system with non-conservative forces? Actually, the works done by these forces add up to zero, and so the mechanical energy is conserved. Now, this is the principle of conservation of mechanical energy. If there are no non-conservative forces, as in the example of the freely falling object, or if the sum of the works done by the non-conservative forces is zero, as in the example of the car, the mechanical energy of the system remains constant, and so it is conserved. This is going to be Me final is equal to Me initial, which is constant. Now, we have Me final is equal to Me initial, which is constant. This is going to be Ke final plus Pe final is equal to Ke initial plus Pe initial. Rearrange. Ke final minus Ke initial is equal to the negative of Pe final minus Pe initial. Now, Ke final minus Ke initial is equal to delta Ke. And Pe final minus Pe initial is equal to delta Pe. So, this is going to be delta Ke is equal to minus delta Pe. This equation says that any increase in the kinetic energy of the system of conserved mechanical energy must be equal to the decrease in its potential energy and vice versa. Let me give you an example. Consider this block. The block slides down a frictionless inclined plane. Now, we will consider three positions of the block along the incline. Let's start with the first position. Now, in this position, Ke1 is equal to zero because the block starts from rest, and take GPE as 5 joules. So the mechanical energy is the sum of its kinetic and gravitational potential energy. Then it will be 5 joules. Now let's take another position. Okay, now in this position, observe that Me is still 5 joules because this is a system with conserved mechanical energy. But look now at the kinetic energy in this position. It is 1 joule. And this makes sense. While sliding down the incline, the weight of the block performs work which results in the transformation of gravitational potential energy into kinetic energy. So the kinetic energy increases and the gravitational energy, potential energy decreases. So the kinetic energy increases from 0 to 1 joule. The gravitational potential energy decreases from 5 to 4 joules. So the increase in Ke is equal to the decrease in GPE. Let's take another position. Now in the final position, mechanical energy is still 5 joules. As you know, it's conserved. Now, look at the kinetic energy. It becomes 5 joules, so it increases now from 1 joule to 5 joules, so it increases by 4 joules. Now, the GPE decreases from 4 joules to 0, so Ke increases by 4 joules, and GPE decreases by 4 joules, which satisfies the last equation.
Non-conserved mechanical energy. In a system, if we have more than one non-conservative force, if the sum of the works done by these non-conservative forces is not equal to zero, so the mechanical energy of this system varies, and it is given by this formula. Delta ME represents the variation of the mechanical energy between two instants equal the sum of the work done by the non-conservative forces between these two instants. So, from this formula, we can conclude that if the sum of the work done by the non-conservative forces equal to zero, then delta M is zero, or the mechanical energy is conserved, as in the previous example when the car moves with a constant speed along a horizontal road. Now, let's take an example where a block slides along a rough inclined plane. At the top of the inclined plane, the kinetic energy of the block is zero since it starts from rest. Gravitational potential energy equal 5 joules relative to a certain reference level, so the mechanical energy equal 5 joules. At another position, the kinetic energy increases from 0 to 0.5, while the gravitational potential energy decreases from 5 to 4, and the mechanical energy decreases from 5 to 4.5. So the mechanical energy in this case is not conserved, because in this system, the sum of the work done by the non-conservative forces is not equal to zero. The normal reaction and the resistive or the friction force are two non-conservative forces in this situation. Finally, at the bottom of the inclined plane, we notice that the mechanical energy decreases and becomes 2.5 joules, which is not equal to 5 joules.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.